million Americans, descendants of almost every race in the world. The city extends a traditional welcome to the Shah and the Empress with a shower of paper streamers and confetti as they drive up Broadway.
Your Majesties, I speak on behalf of all of my fellow Americans in welcoming you to the United States. The interest of both of us is the same, to maintain our freedom, to maintain our peace, and to provide a better life for our people. That is the purpose of your visit, Your Majesty, as to how we can jointly concert that effort.
Mr. President, it's a most pleasant opportunity for the Empress and myself to be able, thanks to your very kind invitation, to visit your great and beautiful country. Today, the name of America has a magic meaning for the most distant communities of the world. I bring with me the heartfelt greetings of my countrymen to your people, with the expression of their sincerest feelings of friendship. And I extend to you, Mr. President, my warm wishes for the happiness and prosperity of your great and noble nation.
Cape Canaveral, home of the American Space Agency. Center of scientific research in outer space. It is here that astronaut John Glenn was launched into his orbital flight around the Earth. Cape Canaveral is a high point in the official visit of the Shah of Iran to the United States in the spring of 1962. To thrust man and equipment across the threshold of space. Canaveral's purpose is simple, its job complex. Thirty-five scientific satellites have rocketed from these launch pads since 1958. Nine are still in orbit, sending back data that expands man's knowledge of the universe. 22,000 scientists and technicians man the National Aeronautics and Space Administration Launch and Communications Center. During flight, this is the nerve center of a world-circling network of 16 tracking stations which maintain continual communication with the space capsule. Man rides through space in an intricate vehicle containing more than 10,000 parts. In coming years, Cape Canaveral will launch a three-man spacecraft to the moon. In the United States Capitol in Washington, members of Congress hear the Shah speak of the friendship, respect, and firm alliance that exists between the people of Iran and the United States.
America gave us generous and valuable financial and military assistance, thus greatly facilitating our task in the implementation of our vast economic and general development and security plans, for which I wish to express to you our deep gratitude and sincerest thanks. We are absolutely certain that the freedom and security of peoples around the world, as well as your own security, depend upon the will and determination of the American people to continue with the struggle without flagging. We hope that you decide, as you have in the past, that it is worthwhile. But I can assure you that whatever your decision may be, that the people of Iran have not maintained their freedom for 2,500 years in order to now surrender.